Now let us see the next topic. Parts always add to give a whole. Now how the parts are added to give the whole? Let us see with an example. Now consider a circle with center O and divide the circle into 8 equal parts, means 8 sectors. Now there are 8 equal sectors, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So out of these 8 sectors, 2 sectors are shaded. Now how much percentage of the whole circle is shaded? Now the shaded part is 2 sectors out of 8 sectors. Now percentage of shaded part equals to 2 out of 8 into 100%. Now this equals to 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8. So then 4 ones are 4, 4 25s are 100. So this equals to 25%. Now percentage of unshaded part can be found by subtracting the shaded part from 100%. Now this equals to 100% means the whole minus the shaded part 25%. Now this equals to 75%. Now the if the shaded part is 25%, then the unshaded part is 75%. So here 25% plus 75% gives the whole, that is 100%. Now let us see whether 75% is correct or not. You will find the percentage of unshaded part. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are 6 parts out of 8 into 100%. Here 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8, 4 1s are 4, 4 25s are 100. So this equals to 25 3s are 75%. So we get 25% plus 75% equals to 100%. Means 25% shaded and 75% unshaded gives the total percent is 100%. Now for example, in a class there are 40% boys and 60% girls. So then 40% plus 60% equals to the total 100%. Now the parts always add to give the whole. Now for example, 10% plus 20% plus 30% plus dash equals to 100%. Now what is the blank? So 10 plus 20, 30, 30 plus 30, 60. Now 60% plus what equals to 100%? So obviously we know that it is 40%. So we can fill up this blank by 40%. Now let us take another example. 25% plus 35% plus dash equals to 100%. Now what is the blank? Yeah, 25 plus 35, 60. Now 60 plus 40 gives 100. So we can write 40%. So parts are always added to give the whole. So to get the whole means 100%, we can add the different percentages. Now let us see the next topic, that is fun with estimation. So the percentage helps us to estimate the percentage of an area. For example, there is a square. Now square is divided into 4 equal triangles. Now out of these 4 equal triangles, means 4 triangles of equal area, the 3 triangles are shaded Now how much part of the square has been shaded? If you want to find, if you want to estimate how much part of the square has been shaded, so then we write now percentage of shaded area of square. Now this equals to, so out of 4 equal triangles, 3 triangles are shaded. So we write 3 out of 4 into 100%. Now this equals to 4 ones are 4 and 4 25s are 100. So 25 threes are 75%. Now the percentage of shaded area of square is 75%. Now the percentage of unshaded area equals to 100% minus 75%, so that equals to 25%. So 75% of the square is shaded and 25% of the square is unshaded. Now let us see the next topic, use of percentages. How to interpret the percentages? So far you have learnt how to convert the percentages to decimals or fractions. Now how to convert the fractions or decimals to the percentages. Now let us see how to use the percentages in our daily life. Now for example, Ramu saved 20% of his income. So in a particular month he saved 20% of his income. So we are using 25%. So 25% of his whole income means if his income is 100, then he is saving 20 rupees. If his income is 1000 rupees, then he is saving 200 rupees. So if you say in the percentage, so his saving is 20% of his income. Now for example, let us take another situation. Now Ranga gets 15% profit in his every item sold. So if he sold anything, then he gets 15% profit in every item sold. Now here also we are using the percent symbol 15% to mention his profit. So in many ways we use the percentage in our day-to-day life. Then how to convert the percentage to how many, means converting the percentages to how many. For example, in a class of 40 students, 25% of students play cricket. So we don't know how many students play the cricket, means, but we know the percentage of the students who play cricket. Now let us find how many students actually play the cricket. Now let us find, now number of students who play cricket. Equals to, so that is 25% of the total students 40. Now this can be written as 25 by 100. So your percentage represents by 100 per every 100. So we wrote by 100 into the total number of students in the class is 40. Here we can cancel 25 ones are 25 and 25 fours are 100. So 4 ones are 4, 4 tens are 40. So this equals to 10. So 25% means there are 10 students who play cricket. Now how many students do not play cricket? That is 75%. The remaining students means 100% minus 25% is 75% students do not play the cricket. So in this way we can find out percentages to how many. You can convert the percentage to how many. Not only how many students, how many students who play the cricket and how many students who do not play the cricket. So whatever it is given in the question, that can be converted into how many.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.